because this is a new product. So you have a new technique. And there's a few features that you have to understand, and it makes sense as far as the technique's concerned. Okay, so this thing at maxed out pressure is gonna be 2000 PSI. Okay, when we have our regular airless sprayers, typically guys have them jacked up to 3300 PSI all the way, and they're just blowing and kicking and going. Some guys will bring it down to about 2500 PSI. Okay, so what happens is when you're slowing your process down, you also have to slow your wrist action down. Okay, you have to get a little bit closer. Okay, so with this unit, on a regular unit, you're gonna be about 12 inches away from a substrate and spraying pretty consistently, okay? And your wrist is gonna be whipping up and down or horizontal. With this unit, you're only at 2000 PSI, so you're gonna wanna slow your wrist down and go ahead and get about 8 to 10 inches into the substrate, okay? And I can show you an example of it.
Just for everybody's information, probably about half of our staff has used this product on exteriors. It's waterborne and it's really thick, so we're kind of pushing this unit.
So one of the things, is it okay if I spray just right here? Okay, so one of the things is if we've got an airless sprayer that's cranked up to 3300 PSI and we're just spraying real quick, you're gonna immediately pull this out of the box and you're gonna be like, well, that sucks. Well, yeah, it sucks. It's not supposed to look like that. So again, it goes into getting closer to the substrate and slowing your wrist action down. That looks a hell of a lot better. So it's just that little simple technique as far as slowing it down, get dialed in a little bit closer, and then you're gonna be good to go. 50 feet, you gotta fill up that hose, you're using a lot more product. You've probably got about, for a door, you know, bid out maybe about 3 to 4 hours prep time, okay? With this, you can cut that process down to an hour or even a half an hour, so. So he also brought it in about 6 more inches.
Okay. What happens?
Well, if you cut down that distance, it's going to give you a little bit more buildup. And so, I don't know if it's going to blend or lay down together.
And do you have to release the trigger?
I was just, my concern was having with the fan sideways, getting down here and getting the underside of this. And I like to spray that way anyway.
Okay, everybody take the gun, you guys can shoot it outside.
Next.
Can fill it up with paint.
She was hot, she was singing, don't turn around. on the